Welcome everybody. We're in the gym now, and as you can see, this is Alan Shields, say hi to the crowd. He is working in maintenance with Chris Alexander, our maintenance supervisor, and they took these bleachers that were totally disassembled earlier this week. I mentioned that we had 9 of our parishioners up here helping to lug them up from Sheehan's store. They're now almost fully assembled, and once done, we'll do a cleaning and then install them against this far wall. I believe we have roughly 68 to 69 total foot of bleachers. There'll be 3 foot left on either end of the bleachers where those who perhaps are in a wheelchair, somebody disabled, will be able to sit during the activities that they're observing. So that's a very positive thing. Now, I mentioned multiple times that we've acquired all of these materials in order to finalize our work here in a gym for no cost. These bleachers served in the Redstone facility, if you can believe it, for roughly 60 years, from the mid-50s until we brought them up here in 16, I think it was, that we brought them up. So it's been 3.5 years, roughly, that they've been over in Sheehan's store, what has been our warehouse for all these materials that we've been gathering in order that we could complete the work in our new facility. As I mentioned, the 9 individuals that were here the other night, one of them was John Ball. He was waxing poetic about his days at Redstone High School and how he would be the athlete that he was in the gym, resting sometimes on these bleachers and just participating in all sorts of sporting activities while he was a student. And these bleachers were new in those days. I'm not trying to say how old John is, but they served an extraordinary important purpose for what was Redstone High School that became just a Redstone facility. And over the years, they had all sorts of athletic activities there for the various leagues in Republic and Brownsville and the surrounding area. But we're just so excited that we have these bleachers. As I said, probably next week sometime, they'll be attached to the floor and to the wall, and we'll have them cleaned in a way that we'll be all set to begin when ultimately we have the backboards, the rims, the floor painted. Can't do the painting until the backboards are in place, so we'll know where to put the free throw lines and the out of bound lines. But we're just so excited to be progressing the way we are. And once we're released from these restrictions in terms of social distancing and when we cannot gather, we'll be starting our various athletic programs and, of course, having all sorts of social activities here in our open space. Matter of fact, very soon we'll be celebrating Corpus Christi, the weekend of the 13th and 14th of June, and we'll have an array of posters, roughly 150 posters with images and the details about Eucharistic miracles that have happened over the last 2 millennia. It's so impressive. I had done that at a previous parish, and the people received it and were just overwhelmed with the information and how significant it was in terms of deepening their faith, their appreciation for the gift of the Blessed Sacrament. So, once again, thank you for joining us, and we look forward to the days that we can gather again here in our new facility and just celebrate being members of our faith community.